that's an unmissable Parkinson at 10:15. That's after we go behind the scenes of Acorn Antiques.
West End one day in a taxi. I was looking at all the posters of all the musicals and I suddenly had this idea, Acorn Antiques, that would be a brilliant poster. So I wrote a musical to go with it. And that got people very baffled because they said, how can Acorn Antiques be a full-length musical when it was just a three-minute sketch on the telly? The thing is, you can't just write a musical and put it on. You have to tell people about it. So we're having this huge press launch. And I don't think Andrew Lloyd Webber has to do this, but we're having to stand in the street with marigold gloves on, holding cups of tea, just to get our names in the papers.
I did an interview yesterday with this woman on the phone from Media Standard, and she said, so where's the show going to be? And I said, it's Royal Haymarket. And she said, oh, and are you hoping to transfer? I said, what? The regions.
Hi, Katie from IRN.
Hi, Katie.
Nice
to meet you.
No, I'm not Mrs. Overall. She's my favourite of all time. So to be able to have her sing
and dance.
And, well, we call it dancing. We call it dancing.
Nice to meet you.
Where should we? Are you standing? Are you all right?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Oh, God.
As long as it's not for too long.
No, no.
Let's firstly talk to you, Victoria. Take us right back to the very beginning. I mean, you know,
of a time, lot of
this... So how did this come about? Because this was your idea. Did you make her audition?
No, strangely. No, she's only ever auditioned for one thing that I've ever written, and that was in 1978. Since then, I've really gathered that she can do it.
Why did you revive Acorn Antiques? Where did... Why this now?
Sorry. Could you speak English? It's so hard to
understand. Why revive it now?
Why revive it? I haven't revived it. This is a musical. If I'd revived it, it would be a three-minute sketch on the television. It's a grey old morning in December, but this is the day when all the cast and the production team get together for the first time. Our director is Trevor Nunn, best director of musicals in the world ever, and we haven't filmed him much, so I'll just tell you, he's got a beard and a denim shirt, and that vivid description will have to do for now. There's my friend Julie, that's me. That's Neil Morrissey in the middle, who Julie didn't even know was in it. That's Celia and Duncan. Gareth Valentine, the musical supervisor. Les Brotherston, the designer. That's the music department, Nick, Sylvia and Dave. Oh, that's Myra, goes everywhere on a fold-up bike. Shireen, the wardrobe mistress. Me again. Oh, that's Hilary, who has the hardest job in the show. More about that later.
I'm near you, you say, Smithick.
And that's Josie Lawrence, just working out that if you take your coat off, you won't be so hot.
Oh, that's better.
Try and where you were before.
Right.
Tap out your neck, your neck, and tap. So that's the one you. That's it.
Lead the arm.
Yeah. No wait. And again. Five, six, seven, eight. One. Tap out.
Now I don't know why I'm wearing a marigold glove to rehearse this song. I've no idea.
The kettle is on. I do not shirk. A cup of tea.
Change again.
I've walked 20 minutes already. I'm absolutely done in. I have peaked even before the dance rehearsal started.
People may think of them as just television people, but they're absolutely not. And they've all been in the theatre for, you know, nearly 30 years, some of them. So they have a huge, huge wealth of experience to draw. Now, luckily, Julie can dance. Julie can tap anyway. Celia's ballet trade, Josie can sing beautifully. Sally's a singer and dancer. Duncan, I think, would say he was not the most adept of tap dancers, and he seems to have held off with his tap dancing.
Oh, the dancing. If you ask me what I feel when I'm in a dance number...
I can't sing, and I can't dance.
My first instinct is to vamoose. It's like... torture because I cannot dance.
I know he's very worried about the tap dancing. I'm absolutely determined to get him absolutely more involved.
I just admire people who can do it. What they pick up in an hour and a half, I'd probably need 3 weeks.
But he has a wonderful voice. I'm absolutely shocked at Duncan singing.
And what's really lovely is that he sings. He has a great voice, but he sings like you would expect Mr. Clifford to sing.
Don't bother to say, oh man, the terrible news I've already heard.
Because when we first came into rehearsal, he was sort of speaking, singing very low. He was back to everybody at the piano, and I thought, oh dear, poor old Duncan, he's struggling.
Someone must go, a point must be made. President's marking the ruin of trade.
And then he sang it out. It was absolutely fantastic.
Please stay here, where your life will be simple and clear.
Celia, of course, you know, absolutely gorgeous and full of sexual energy. And my character in the second half has to sort of win her heart over.
Forgive me, I feel so apologetic. Had a tooth filled, I'm still full of anaesthetic.
A filling? Now I'm getting up to think you might be swelling up.
I want you, I'm humbled by my neediness. I crave your sweet chewiness and tweediness. Without you, I'm up against the ropes, I'm floored.
She is so funny in it. You know, the perfect English lady, rather grand. And the most wonderful dancer and mover.
Not near the antiques.
When I first heard about it, I thought, oh, Lord, because... Everyone's going to see how old we are now. You know, what's...
Oh, there goes a Zimmer frame.
Victoria Wood.
Victoria is obviously, I mean, what a mind to conceive of this in the first place.
I do look at this writing and think, God, I wish I could do that.
She's written the script, she's written the songs. She's there all the time.
Who's singing Gosh, That Lovely Dosh at the moment? You are. But it would be better if she had two lines. Yeah. Okay.
Okay, thank you. Back in a minute.
She wrote the songs, which I think is going to surprise a lot of people. I know that she is known for writing songs, but some of these songs are just so beautiful.
Close the window, light the lamp, the evening star is fading.
You know, when you get it right, she'll laugh at the jokes that she's written that you're saying. And I think she's so generous. I mean, God knows. I've said this before, but I mean, she is glorious the way she gives away these cracking lines to everybody else.
I can tell by the heavage, the swell of your cleavage, how wild you are. Imagine a climax as big as the IMAX. It's a cinema.
She's a mega chick to work for. Hey.
Hit the floor, por favor. Why not? No, you do what you do.
Okay, my darling. I like that.
She's a wonderful mover. She's naturally incredibly inventive and very creative with her comedy.
As Julie does this, we should do. Watch as the cat put into her. Like an Ann Miller, so she's so doing it on. Watch as we have.
Hang on. So it's watch as we have you. But more than a hurricane.
You might want
King John's an addict.
So she brings hundreds and hundreds of different rainbows of comedy to what she's doing.
Tap it up. Tap it up. Can't you choose? Watch, come through, everybody. Go. Come through now, so you actually barge through. Go. You hit the floor. Oh, for
Why not?
She's totally professional. And if you see her in the rehearsal room, she'll either be asleep, which is fine, or she'll be looking at her words. She's never just sort of messing about. That's why she gets the laughs she does, because everything she does, she'll be standing in the right place on the stage, she'll be looking at the right person, and she'll know the words. And I think she's utterly marvellous. And I feel so blessed that I've been able to work with her all this time.
How's Tom?
Oh, busy as ever.
Dowag but say. Okay, I see your dowag but and raise you new bag.
I'll take your new bag and raise you new gardener.
I'll see your eye candy and raise you mystique.
Mystique? Wow. And all I've got left is.
Yes, please.
New breasts.
Dow Egbert's Coffee, a cup above.
Build a country wide, the people who will sell your home.
Phone us now for your free market valuation.
Build a country wide.
Fly with Cosmar to the Greek islands Corfu, Crete and Rhodes. New for this summer from Exeter International Airport. Flying you further from closer to home.
Get a free DVD of the film Last Orders, starring Michael Caine, Helen Mirren, Bob Hoskins and Ray Winstone. Only inside tomorrow's Sunday Telegraph.
What can I get for 50p, Dad?
50p? Well...
What about this?
Maybe.
What about that? Dad? Dad?
I tell you what, we'll have a word.
50p!
Our prices aren't that low, but it's hard to find lower. That's Comet Sense.
New Jacob's Essentials, full of tasty herbs, seeds and whole grains. Natural sources of nutrients and energy.
Amen!
It really doesn't do to forget the essentials.
Many Chinese believe the number 8 brings prosperity. That's why in Hong Kong, people will pay millions of dollars for a number plate. At HSBC, we also believe that 8 can bring you prosperity, because now you can earn 8% on regular savings fixed for a year. 8% on your savings, a great reason to bank with HSBC.
Stay calm.
What are you doing here?
In the bouquet of a vintage vino.
Chateau Latour, 1961.
DCI Barnaby can smell a fish.
And there's nothing like a little bit of truth to sell the biggest lies, is there?
John Nettles returns in a brand new case, Midsummer Murders, Sunday at 9.
Squeeze your inside thighs. Squeeze your buttocks. Oh, 5, 6, 7, and...
Here we go.
We're really on our way.
to squeeze you like a luscious avocado. You remind me of an English Bridget Bardot. I'm very hard, I'm very tough, but suddenly not tough enough. You have overwhelmed...
And for our younger viewers, Celia and Neil also do the voices of Bob the Builder and Sally the Hippo.
Without... Oh, bollocks. What is it?
I'll stop now.
I'll stop now.
Ooh, let's go along.
It's physically very demanding. There's the doddery walk, the varicose veins, the hemorrhoids. That's not Mrs. Overall, that's Julie.
Why not?
Last week, I didn't sleep a bloody wink. I was absolutely terrified as to whether I could pull this off, you know, whether I'm actually capable of doing it, so I didn't sleep very well.
And done.
We're dancing even faster now. We're shaking loose the plaster now. We're heading for
to Julie's feet.
Watch while we tap you up a storm, then a hurricane.
I kind of know the tap number now. That was the big one I was worried about, so I feel much more relaxed this week.
Keep Julie, these low, these
King low. Johnson and Edmund James, farewell to aches and adios pains. Tap away your varicose veins, don't slip.
So we do too.
Sorry.
So don't worry, you're right.
Singing is very tiring. It's a very muscular sort of thing, much more than people realise, much more than I realised. And then dancing as well, it's another language, dance and steps, and I find that very hard to get my head around. And now, but once you sort of start getting it, it's a fabulous feeling.
The reason I'm standing behind Julie like some sort of deranged, choreographed stalker is that somehow I've ended up agreeing to play Mrs. Overall myself for two performances a week so that Julie can go to bingo. And part of me thinks that'll be fine, because I think I can sort of do it. And part of me is really scared about it. Oh, let's go for it.
Marvellous.
Hillary's job is much harder. She's the third Mrs. Overall. If Julie falls down the stairs and lands on top of me, Hillary will have to go on. But she's not just our understudy, she's playing her own part in the show, and she's understudying six other parts, including Celia's, so she's got to learn seven completely different characters. And I think she also has a paper round and works in a charity shop.
We're heading for...
I think it's nature's laxative, to be honest. I'm trying to learn my own show because I'm obviously in the show, and then watching what Celia's doing, what Julie Walters is doing, what the five ensemble that I'm covering are doing, and I'm just like octopus head. It's so scary, but I'm loving it.
Oh, it was an accident. I was cleaning the bath. Your father slipped on a cake of Lifebuoy and his private parts went up the kick pleat.
I tell you what, I've got to stop doing it, stop enjoying myself in rehearsals. Because Victoria's writing is so funny, you just find yourself being an audience all the time. Then you suddenly go, hang on, we'll concentrate. What do they do then?
Somebody offered her a cocktail. The next thing you know, she's headed for Bermuda with a trunk full of provocative scanties. If she stuck to a lattice jam tartan of Vimto, all this could have been avoided. If she'd stuck to a lattice... If she stuck to a lattice jam tartan of Vimto, all this could have been avoided. All this could have been avoided.
You have to check yourself every now and again and go, no, lines, lines, lines.
But if Julie falls down the stairs on top of me and Hillary comes round the corner and thinks we're both dead and has a heart attack, I don't know who'll play Mrs. Overall. Trevor Nunn in a hairnet, possibly.
Oh,
This is Darren, who's doing the wigs for the show. I think everybody in the cast has at least one wig, probably two. It's only me and Julie, playing the ancient Mrs. Overall, who've been told to use our own hair. Thanks, Darren.
I'll try that one.
Thanks. Whenever I feel worried about playing Mrs. Overall, I just put on that hat. And there's the character, all done for you.
No acting required.
Are we going mad here?
I think we are going mad. We've lost the track. We've lost track of where we are. I think I know what to do.
It's kind of the right thing.
Yeah, wear it with the peak more round the front.
You dress it.
so you get that kind of jaunty thing.
It's got to be the jaunty.
The cap and the trouser suit is the costume for Beau Beaumont, who is the actress who plays Mrs. Overall. She's rather grand. Hence the pashmina.
Stop giggling.
No, I can't believe I've agreed to play this part. It seems really ludicrous.
I think this is glamour.
No, well, for me, it is.
You've got to be very careful, haven't we? I think it's got to look ridiculous.
Yeah.
But not necessarily just across the bust.
In the show, Miss Babs has fibbed about her cup size to the wardrobe woman.
And then she still thinks she looks marvellous.
Yeah.
But actually, she looks ridiculous.
I think get that kind of darkness is good. I mean, what's great is when you
Ooh, those shops are very small, Les. I don't think we're going to fit through the door. They built the shop. There's no turning back. Everything's going great, actually. The set's built, the posters are up. Trevor's got through an amazing amount of work in 3 weeks. And now we have the enforced 10-day cracker and flatulence break, known in this country as Christmas. They come from the festivities, refreshed and ready for work.
It's been a blur of sugar and exhaustion. Thank you.
Oh, that's Trevor. None, the director. There he is again. That's the back of his head. You'll see him later. We need to get going, because I've got these script changes. Oh. Mwah. Yes, I love you too. Mwah. Just I've made a few cuts in the script. We need to give them out. Oh, Julie, you stop. Kissing people. Got to hand these cuts. Oh, it's been kissing people for nearly 5 hours now. Okay, Katie, hand them round.
Instead it goes, we love our city, we want to extol her name. The sun comes up and points a golden ray. So you miss out that whole minor section.
I feel crummy when I have to take stuff off people, but in the end, my responsibility is to the audience.
I haven't talked to Stephen about it as well yet.
Shall I just do it
just
lightly?
Just do it in pencil.
You can do it in crayon because it's going anyway.
Scripts and pencils at the ready. Yeah. Here we go.
I'm trying to get the show down to my ideal length, but even little cuts really confuse everybody.
You should have.
We're on our way. Babs, Bertha, Clifford.
We're having now because we're on our way to fix step.
I would love to take 20 minutes out of the show, but that 20 minutes is stuff people have rehearsed and worked on and have got fond of. It's complicated. If you cut somebody's song, it hurts their feelings. But if you keep it in and they end up singing it to an audience who are worried about missing their last bus home, then you haven't done your job.
We haven't. Hang on. It should be, hey, hey, run away with me and Toby, we'll be so delighted.
Yeah.
I think the easiest thing would be to throw coffee all over the script and then just do the bits we can still read. Well, look, let's not get bogged down with the songs that we haven't got. Let's learn the tunes of the ones that are still with us, shall we, Duncan?
Down a little bit.
Oh, you did just then?
Yeah.
I don't know how.
When the wind is in your head.
Oh, we will never be with you. Then it's the gun and the fist. You are too old or you are too pissed to leave this. Find the target who seeks for the honour. A bacon antiques cheer, bury away.
You see, I've still got to learn my lines. I don't just go around hurting people's feelings.
Some Garibaldis and a lemonade. Take the antiques and build a barricade. Waving, waving.
You broke my heart and then you broke it twice. And now you're back, you have to pay the price.
We've cut four numbers out of the show, but I'm still trying to write numbers for Celia's character and Duncan's. Celia's I'm having real trouble with, but this one I'm hoping will work, so fingers crossed.
I'm back on top, so what did you expect? That I would stop and lose my self-respect. I'm not the kind of woman that would ever run and hide. I'm back on top, and my eyes are dry.
My bank gave me a great mortgage deal 2 years ago. It started low, but it's now about to shoot up! They think I can't move because it's too much hassle. My bank is having a laugh. What do I look like, a fool?
There is another way. If your mortgage deal with Halifax, Abbey or Cheltenham and Gloucester is ending, talk to NatWest. We'll lower your new monthly repayments or give you £100. We'll also give you a decision in minutes. No wonder we've been voted best bank for mortgages a record 11 times.
First has been answered.
New Renault Modus. Grow up, what for?
They call me Mellow Yellow.
Quite rightly.
They call me Mellow Yellow.
Quite rightly.
They call me Mellow Yellow.
Mr. Kipling's new lemon drizzle cake. Soaked through with real lemons. Mr. Kipling, exceedingly good cakes.
Fancy doing something different with potatoes? Leave it to the experts.
If you can't get the mortgage deal you want, talk to NatWest and see if we could give you a better deal right now.
Tonight on Parkinson, comic genius Peter Kay.
How's your nan?
She wants to know when Give Us a Clue's coming back.
TV favourite Nicholas Lyndhurst and Hollywood actress Sandra Bullock.
Your mother was not for a singer.
Obviously, as was my father.
What kind of channel was it?
Loud.
Parkinson, after Acorn Antiques.
We watch, we're happy now, because we're on our way. Just take a step and then another step, it's easy and you've come.
In the show, Miss Babs takes on two pitiful adolescents from a government training scheme. They're Gareth and Jenna, who aren't exactly adolescents, but compared with the rest of us, they have at least got their